Procreate updated the software so it now has barrel rotation. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set it up and talk about how effective it is. So let's go. Okay, so we're inside of Procreate and we have everything set up. I have the new Apple Pencil and the new iPad Pro. So let's just talk about the main features, the barrel rotation. Okay. So when you have your brushes, so I have all my brushes in here created, I label my brushes with rotation. The reason why I label rotation is so I know the distinction between what's set to the barrel versus tilt rotation. So you'll see I have them all labeled. Now, what you'll see here is if I go ahead and click and then we go inside to the shape, okay, what you'll notice is right in here is where you want to make sure you activate to azimuth and barrel roll. This is where it's going to allow you to rotate your brush. Okay, so now that we have it, when we come inside here, so you can see this, let's move this over to the side a little bit here. Okay, so if you look, you can't tell what the rotation is. So what do we do here? So to show your cursor, you want to go to Actions, Brush Cursor, and then you can also go into Advanced Brush Cursor Settings. I'm going to have Show While Hovering and High Contrast. You can also play around with these, but the main thing is I want to show while hovering, and then we'll go ahead and start to paint. So now if you look, I can spin, okay, the Apple Pencil in my hand. If you pull away, if you get a certain distance, about, I would say it's almost about an inch, you can't see it anymore. So you got to get down to about a half an inch to be able to see the rotation. Okay, so you can see it spin in your hand. So now with this, depending on how your brush is set up, you're going to get different effects. Okay, so let's just say I love that brush, so I'll come back to it in a minute, but let's go with this one for a second. Okay, so I have it set to thick to thin pressure as well, not just rotation. So what you'll notice is when I press heavy, it gets fat and thin, but I can also chisel and go sideways and then rotate like this and get it real thin. So I'm getting 2 to 3, maybe 4 different actions on this particular brush. And this is why I love barrel rotation and why I always love it and why I'm able to get very painterly paintings, that you can do it the other way, but it's a lot more work. Okay, so let's go ahead and get these out of here. Okay, so now that we have this set up, let's go ahead and show you another little thing that's going on here. So with the haptic squeezing, I have mine set up to show layers. So what you can see with the haptic squeeze, if I click down, it'll show me what layer is underneath. So I have this set up. So right now you can see layer mask, insert, impressionist. So if I click in different locations, you'll see right here, let's do that again. It shows exactly what layers are underneath the Apple Pencil tip at that moment. I love this feature. I use this in Photoshop and Corel Painter quite a bit. Fantastic. So that I love having this. So let me show you how I have that set up. If you go under your actions and we go into our gesture controls, you'll see I have under layer select and then I have Apple Pencil squeeze. So this is fantastic. And then I have the double tap with my finger for my eyedropper so I can grab any color that I want. Okay. And then the way I'm getting this texture is the layer on top has all of the textures, canvas textures set to different blend modes, multiply and overlay. I have a layer underneath. So now if I go ahead and start to paint this texture in there, okay, you can see I'm getting this canvas texture, but it's not just the texture above, it's also the brushes that I have. So if I turn all of these off, you can see my brushes are set to have a canvas texture. So I'm doubling down on the effect to make sure that I can get this really lush painterly effect. And then the other thing is with Procreate, if you click and hold the smudge tool, whatever brush you're using at the time becomes your blender. And because I'm using right here, these brushes, I believe I'm using acrylics. But it doesn't matter. It's going to allow you to smudge and smear some of these colors around the way I have them designed and set up. So I can push and mingle the color in and out of each other. And I can get just this really lush, textural painterly effect that I'm just like, for me, I love. So whenever I can do this on the side for myself, this is kind of what I lean into a lot more versus doing the more realistic tight stuff that I usually get paid to do. Now, we'll go ahead and turn these textures back on for now. Actually, now I'm looking at the textures, they look really heavy. So let's go ahead and take that texture. Let's take that texture opacity way, way down. I don't want it that strong. I want it much more delicate. And then I would add a layer mask and take those things out of there. Now, if you're going to ask me, what do I think about this new Apple Pencil, iPad, and Procreate? For me, blown away, to be honest with you. I'm really excited about it. It's the best thing I've experienced digital painting in a long time. I love Wacom tablets with the art pen. It's been the thing I've been using probably for the last 20 something years digitally painting. They recently discontinued that art pen, and then 2-3 weeks later after I posted a video about it, this came out. And then I got the software, the equipment, everything that we needed. And what ended up happening is the software wasn't ready, but now the software is ready. And I'm going to tell you, I love it. I love it. I'll do another video talking about Adobe Fresco, but right now, for the first time in a long time, I really believe in working on an iPad. I know a lot of people do it professionally already, but you know, I'll just show you. I have this old thing. Remember these things? This thing is heavy, and I've had like iPad after iPad after iPad, and each one of these promised to be like that tool that was going to finally let us be able to digitally paint on our iPads and do all this stuff, and nothing ever came through. It was just, for me, I don't want to say broken promises, you know, the technology just wasn't there yet. But as it is, as of now, it is there. And I'm blown away, I'm shocked. And for those of you who are willing to try something new and use the barrel rotation, you're going to be very happy with it. And the best way I can describe it, because there's a lot of people going back and forth on why you would need this on the last video. The best thing I could say is if you have Copic, right? This brush tip here, this is a chisel. This gives you a completely different look. Now, if someone tells me that you can get the same look with this, you can't. You can't. I mean, or you could by faking it, by drawing in each little square shape, but it's not going to look fresh. It's not going to look energetic. The brush strokes are going to look very controlled and forced. There's no way, you know, and you know, I could easily run long on this video just talking about that alone, but it's different strokes for different folks. I like having a lot of tools, variety of mark making tools, because it allows me to get this kind of expressive painting very easily, where the other way, it just requires way too much work and it doesn't feel like painting to me. And for me, if it's going to be more work, then I'm just going to go ahead and do it on with real paint. Why would I waste time on a computer? The computer is supposed to make it easier for me, not harder. This iPad and this new pencil right here, what this is able to do, I'm blown away. And that's all I'm going to say. So if you like this video and you want more information on this and digital painting and teaching and all those different things, subscribe, hit the bell notification below, and I'll see you next time.